This is the Blaring Out with Eric Blair show, and tonight we're here at the Hollywood Forever Cemetery in beautiful Los Angeles, California, for the
6th annual Johnny Ramone tribute with Metallica guitarist Kirk Hammett. How excited are you to be presenting The Bride of Frankenstein in memory of Johnny Ramone?
Well, it's pretty exciting. I mean, you know, Johnny, he was such a character, and a lot of times we would get into these friendly arguments about, you know, weird things like politics and whatnot. But, you know, there was a middle ground that we would always agree on, and that was horror movies. And we both agreed that Bride of Frankenstein was one of the best horror movies and one of our favorites. And it's a great honor to be able to kind of revisit that memory of him and I just always talking about The Bride of Frankenstein, and to be able to, like, present it in his memory, it means a lot. I'm very honored to be asked. You know, the interesting thing about Bride of Frankenstein is that it was never intended to be a horror movie. It's actually intended to be a comedy. If you watch the film in that light, you'll see a lot of comedy. I can remember hearing a story about James Whale and all his friends watching a private showing of Bride of Frankenstein in 1935 and just laughing the whole way through. And when you watch it, there are a lot of, like, really, really funny parts in it.
Now, also, Johnny Ramone was a huge influence on your rhythm playing, correct?
Yeah. He had the down-picking hand of doom.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was pretty legendary amongst my friends and I. Actually, I read something once about this guy hooking up some sort of machine to his left or his right hand that counted how many downbeats downbeat notes he was hitting while he was playing a song. It was like, I don't know, over 10,000 over the course of a show or something. I actually asked him about it because that was something me and my friends always talked about, and he said, "Oh no, it's just a press thing. I don't listen to any of that stuff." But yeah, he had a rhythm technique that was just phenomenal.
When you think of the Ramones, for you personally, what is the song that you're most touched by?
I have really, really vivid memories of like first hearing the Ramones when I was 14 years old, and it just something that went off inside me, like someone flicked on a light switch inside of me, and I thought, wow, this is great. This is music that I can understand, you know. It spoke to me in a way that not a lot of music did at that time. And just, like, you know, the energy, you know, the comic book-ish sort of, like, presentation, the lyrics. I mean, it's everything a 14-year-old kid, you know, is disenfranchised wanted to hear.
Exactly.
At least in my case, yeah.
What is next for Metallica?
Well, we're going to finish our tour. We've been on tour for about 28 months, and we're going to finish it in November, and then we're going to take some time off, and then sometime maybe in the spring, summer of next year, we're going to consider getting together and writing some new songs for a new album.
Were you happy with the last record?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And we had a pretty good run with it too.
Yeah.
All over the world.
People said it was a return to form for Metallica.
You know, they could say whatever they want. You know, for us, it's putting our nose to the grindstone and getting new music going in 6 or 8 months.
The passing of Dio, how would you reflect on that?
It's a great loss. I mean, he was a big, big influence on my band. Everyone in the band were big Dio fans. It was a small guy with a big voice. I mean, it's a shame, but I mean, all good things come to an end sooner or later, and you just have to really just accept that. I mean, it's just like, you know, in Johnny's case too. But you know, both Ryan James Dio and Johnny, they made such a huge mark on the world, and their influence is still being felt. I mean, you know, it's that in itself is a beautiful thing.
The Blaring Out Show.
Always talking about The Bride of Frankenstein, and to be able to, like, present it in his memory, it means a lot. I'm very honored to be asked. no, the interesting thing about Bride of Frankenstein is that it was never intended to be a horror movie. It's actually intended to be a comedy. If you watch the film in that light, you'll see a lot of comedy. I can remember a story, hearing a story about James Whale and all his friends watching a private showing of Bride of Frankenstein in 1935 and just laughing the whole way through. And when you watch it, there are a lot of like really, really funny parts in it.
Now, also, Johnny Ramone was a huge influence on your rhythm playing, correct?
Yeah. He had the down-picking hand of doom.
Yeah.
He's first hearing the Ramones when I was 14 years old, and it just something that went off inside me, like someone flicked on a light switch inside of me, and I thought, wow, this is great. This is music that I can understand. You know, it spoke to me in a way that not a lot of music did at that time. And just like, you know, I have to say that the energy, you know, the comic book-ish sort of like presentation, the lyrics. I mean, it's everything a 14-year-old kid, you know, who's disenfranchised wanted to hear.
Exactly.
At least in my case, yeah.
What is next for Metallica?
Well, we're going to finish our tour. We've been on tour for about 28 months.
This is the Blairing Out with Eric Blair Show, and tonight we're here at the Hollywood Forever Cemetery in beautiful Los Angeles, California, for the
6th annual Johnny Ramone tribute with Metallica guitarist Kirk Hammett. How excited are you to be presenting The Bride of Frankenstein in memory of Johnny Ramone?
Well, it's pretty exciting. I mean, you know, Johnny, he was such a character, and a lot of times we would get into these friendly arguments about, you know, weird things like politics and whatnot. But, you know, there was a middle ground that we would always agree on, and that was horror movies. And we both agreed that Bride of Frankenstein was one of the best horror movies and one of our favorites. And it's a great honor to be able to kind of revisit that memory of him and I. Just pretty legendary amongst my friends and I. Actually, I read something once about this guy hooking up some sort of machine to his left or his right hand that counted how many downbeats downbeat notes he was hitting while he was playing a song. It was like, I don't know, over 10,000 over the course of a show or something. I actually asked him about it because that was something me and my friends always talked about, and he said, "Oh no, it's just a press thing. I don't listen to any of that stuff." But yeah, he had a rhythm technique that was just phenomenal.
When you think of the Ramones, for you personally, what is the song that you're most touched by?
You know, I have really, really vivid memory, and we're going to finish it in November, and then we're going to take some time off, and then sometime maybe in the spring, summer of next year, we're going to consider getting together and writing some new songs for a new album.
Were you happy with the last record?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And we had a pretty good run with it too.
Yeah.
All over the world.
People said it was a return to form for Metallica.
You know, they could say whatever they want. You know, for us, it's putting our nose to the grindstone and getting new music going in 6 or 8 months.
The passing of Dio, how would you reflect on that?
It's a great loss. I mean, he was a big, big influence on my band. Everyone in the band were big Dio fans.